The New Zealand Army is on a large-scale multinational military exercise in Fiji, the first of its kind because it's led by the United States, ramping up its Pacific presence to counter rising Chinese influence. Pacific correspondent Barbara Dreaver and cameraman Nick Zelchis were on the front lines in the Fijian Highlands, and they've just sent in this exclusive report.
Reforging links made in World War II. For the first time, Exercise Cartwheel is bringing together the same allies which once fought side by side in the Solomon Islands.
Yeah, look, I think there's a whole range of vectors that are challenging the security environment. You know, having that familiarity and that trust and those relationships through training ensures we're ready. And the opportunity to work alongside our Pacific partners, conducting what is the fundamentals of combat training, is key for us.
The Pacific landscape is rapidly changing. Climate change is a big issue, but it's China's growing influence in the region which is causing concern. It's why this US training exercise in Fiji is so important.
Now we now face challenges that needs a collective whole to address. We address them together. When I talk about threats, I talk about natural disasters. I talk about illegal fishing. And I talk about other traditional non-state actors which try and destabilize this part of the world.
Exercise Cartwheel is providing the platform for the five military forces to work together. They're training in jungle and urban operations.
What do you want us on?
This is about building readiness for military action and capacity to face a crisis.
It's the first time in decades that this type of military exercise has been held in the Pacific. Led by the US and Fiji, involves five nations and around 270 military personnel.
For the Kiwis, it's a relief to get back to business. 2 years of doing security at MIQ facilities has resulted in hundreds of personnel leaving defence.
It's been awesome to get back and do our jobs again. And it's kind of given everyone like a wee pick-me-up, to be honest. And it's been nice to get back, take the masks off and put the camouflage back on.
From a regional security perspective, having Fiji as a major military partner is key.
We feel that we are not alone. And they also treat us as equal partners in this move forward.
You know, it's fundamental to what we do. We are part of the Pacific. And with that in mind, we have an obligation to work alongside these folks.
A shared history is the platform for the US to firm up old partnerships. The Pacific at the centre of a battle for influence.
And that's the truth. Barbara Dreaver joins us now live from Suva. Barb, this is fascinating, and it's big picture, Pacific strategy, right? How important is this for the US, and where does it leave New Zealand's relationship with Fiji?
Well, look, it's extremely important because, of course, Kiribati and the Solomon Islands have recently been ramped up by their influence with China. China's right in there, and that's really concerning the US. Of course, Kiribati borders the US waters and is close to military installations. So you can understand that operation, that this cartwheel is really crucial to the US. What we have is Fiji, New Zealand, Australia, and the UK all involved in this. And, you know, they've come with all the bells and whistles, John, up at the camp. They have all the mod cons. They're out there. They're bigger than better than anyone else. But at the end of the day, that is not what counts in the Pacific. It's about relationships. And that's when New Zealand comes in, and they do very well at it. I was talking to some of the Fiji military, and they say that working with New Zealand, they just gel with New Zealand. And that's extremely important. When New Zealand leaves, when this cartwheel is over, then New Zealand will be leaving two soldiers behind. They'll be going to all the villages, replanting what was exploded in the exercise, and they'll also be giving their thanks to the Fijian villages. And that is what counts in the Pacific.
That's our excellent Pacific correspondent, Barbara Dreaver, live from Fiji. Thanks, Barb.